gathering up these mushrooms to put in my little basket.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, do you know why I'm dressed like a bear right now?
We'll get to that later. First things first, we gotta start this show.
Is that all?
Yeah.
It feels like it was only yesterday.
Dean, shut up. I gotta say one thing. We fucking missed you guys. Did you miss us? I'll tell ya, I missed the blood, I missed the guts, I missed the boobs, and most importantly, I missed the butts.
Nuts here at Boner Bazaar. We originally designed the concept for this show, Midsummer Night's Dream, after the theme of religious hysteria, religious control, religious violence. We did this as a sort of fun escape from the problems of our everyday life. Unfortunately.
Unfortunately, life imitates art. A Christo-fascist court has hijacked our human rights and our country. On behalf of me and everyone here backstage tonight, I just want to say, fuck that. Fuck the court. Fuck the judges.
We're all about team building exercises.
All right, here's a team building exercise. I need everyone's help. When I say fuck, you say the courts. Fuck!
The courts!
Fuck!
The courts!
When I say castrate, you say Kim Paxton. Castrate!
Kim Paxton!
Castrate!
Kim Paxton!
Okay, that rhythm's a little weird. That's my fault. Let's try something else. When I say don't, you say litter. Don't!
I feel like you're getting just a little bit too preachy on that one.
Okay, yeah, you know what, you're right. Let me back off. I don't want to make this political or anything. Well, let's get on with the show, shall we? Hey, we've got some lovely sponsors here tonight. And we're going to tell you all about them right now.
The Austin chapter of the Satanic Temple is here tonight. So be sure to check out their booth and see how you can get involved.
Full Moon Apothecary, ritually crafts spiritual and self-care products using the power of the moon. They've got ritual bath salts, candles, spell kits, and more. You can check them and all the other sponsors out over there in the back there, the merch booth.
Lotus Frequency is selling luxurious and inclusive lingerie, harnesses, and accessories.
Yeah, they are. We also have official Boner Bazaar merchandise for sale, so check that out. And we're doing a raffle! People love the raffle, don't they? My God. The prizes include class passes from Mix and Muse, class passes from Black Box. Oh, we got some Mix and Muse fans here. This raffle's for you. Also, Black Box Creative, we've got class passes for that. Also, we have drink tickets to the Little Drinks Lounge, which I will tell you now is the real, actual place where Snake Ticks works. If you get these drink tickets, there's a good chance she'll be there to give you the drinks, and she can't stop you from talking to her.
Shut up. Please, yeah. Just give me all your money. So, it's time to start this show. But before we we just have a few rules to go over for the newcomers. Number one, if you see something you like, yell, scream, laugh, clap, tag us in all your videos on Instagram. Please make noise because we fucking love that shit. Rule number two, do not touch the performers. Leave the perversion to the professionals, us. Rule number three, and this probably goes without saying, but there will be no tolerance for racism, sexism, homophobia, transphobia, or any other type of discrimination. And if you see anyone perpetrating any of the above, tell us and we will throw their asses out! Alrighty, that's all the rules. Are we ready to do this?
Yeah! Let's fucking do this.
Alright. He loves me. He loves me not. Meet the queen of roses, of thorns, and of the May.
The flower-crowned queen walks among you. Please welcome Dev Devamp.
Make some noise, guys!
Thank you.
Give it up one more time for Dev Develop, everybody!
Folks, at this point, I should probably explain, if you haven't seen the movie Midsommar, you're gonna be missing out on a lot of crucial imagery, references, concepts, themes. You should probably get on that. It's kind of crucial for the understanding of this entire arrangement.
I'm probably gonna get a lot of shit for saying this, but I think Midsommar might be the perfect horror movie. At least the best representation of tripping. Yeah. I'm tripping right now. Actually, we saw Midsommar together in the theaters when it came out.
That's right. You have to understand that when we're not wearing awesome costumes, Snake and I are sort of like Wayne and Garth. And, I really felt that during the movie because, anytime something messed up would happen to like an old person or you just like a
the hammer, victim. The hammer came down.
The part with the hammer. That I remember we just reckoned, we were like getting Wayne. We were just like, I was just turning to you constantly and just looking like, you brought me to this.
Well, showing. Let's get into this next performer, shall we? I forget to keep pausing so y'all can woo. I haven't done this in a while.
Feel free to woo whenever. The spread takes you. Wow, this is very easy. Pandering. I love it.
Please pardon my faux pas. Alrighty, Sherry Cola has been pole dancing since 2013 and has enjoyed every minute. She is currently an instructor at Black Box Creative and teaches beginners. That means you.
Yeah, if you win a raffle, for instance. With Sunny's body and Cher's G-string, she struts the stage, mixing classic stripper style with creative concepts. She's Austin's favorite pastel dominatrix. Give it up for Cherry Cola!
I want more money. Once upon a time, not long ago, I was a hoe. And I'm admitting it, I won't take it back. Cause I did this shit, I was a hoe. And I'm admitting it, I won't take it back. Cause I did this shit, I was a hoe. More money, I want your money. I want more money, I want your money. More money, I want your money. I want more money, I want more money.
If you want it, don't deny it. If it's not mine, it always gets provided. If you want it, don't deny it. If it's not mine, it always gets provided.
But no man break your back. You know I like it just like that. But no man break your back. You know I like it just like that. But no man break your back. Come on, just spend this now. But no man break your back. Come on, just spend this now. But bend this now.
Intergalactic, planetary, planetary, intergalactic.
Give it up one more time for Cherry Cole, everybody! And an alien!
Yo, big ups to Heaven's fucking Gate, the only cult I would have joined. I mean, you guys are all in agreement, right? Aliens fucking created us.
Oh, you saw Prometheus.
If you don't believe aliens created us, I got news for you. You are fucking stupid! Bigfoot is real, Chupacabra's real. Dude, the whole time we were like writing this script, he would come over and be like, so what are you doing? I'm like, dude, they're gonna find Bigfoot.
Okay, here's my complaint, okay? Here's the thing. There's like 2 seasons and 8 episodes each season.
3 seasons, and it's 12 episodes.
They never found Bigfoot.
Dude, he has, like, his fur can make him invisible sometimes, and the fucking government knows about him and is hiding him from us.
Yeah, but how do you get, like, 36 episodes out of that?
They found the prints. They found hair. They sent it off. They're like, dude, this is not an animal we know about.
Uh-huh, yeah.
He's real. He's out there, and he is fucking angry.
Is he evil, do you think?
I don't know. I don't think he's an extraterrestrial. I believe he is an ultra-terrestrial. Like, I believe he is of this Earth, but he can slip in and out of a dimension. Shit. And he stinks! That's a big thing. Every person that sees Bigfoot, they'll be like, ah! What's that fucking smell? And then they see Bigfoot.
We should introduce this performer.
I want to talk about Bigfoot.
We can get to that later.
Fine, all right, here we go. Idle hands, self-pleasure, worship thy damn self.
This act is here to remind you to get hot, get bothered, and masturbate your way to hell. Thanks for giving me the eyes for this one. Please welcome Magnetic Cunt!
You heard the preacher.
You think we don't know what you're talking about? What do you mean? It's about holding hands.
You watch your mouth.
You know who's got hands? The devil. And he uses them for holding.
Idle hands are known to be the devil's workshop.
To spread the blood of the innocent.
We definitely have some in the back here. I'm gonna go by and I'm gonna pick up a pamphlet later. It's all about love, it's all about freedom. But actually, can we get back to Bigfoot real quick?
Yes, please!
Okay.
If I could just stand up here and talk about Bigfoot all night, I would. I mean, I don't think that's what these people paid money for, but God damn it, I will talk about Bigfoot.
We don't have to talk about Bigfoot anymore because I'm about to solve this case.
These motherfuckers want fucking Bigfoot!
Bigfoot's over, huh? Bigfoot's over, alright? You wanna believe, you wanna tell me that this Bigfoot motherfucker can phase in and out of dimensions? You're talking about, this is like a wizard. He has wizard powers, but he doesn't wear clothing? He doesn't bathe? What's up with that?
Dude, in this Boner Bizarre house, God damn it, we believe in science! Just look at the science, Dean! He's out there! Hey, it's not just, you know, there's whole families of these things just roaming around, stinking up the place, ripping up trees and making little huts. I would not have sex with Bigfoot, but I would totally fuck the Mothman. Dude's fucking hot, dude. I want him to like take me up into the sky and wrap his little wings around me and like fuck me in the air, and I like look at his little red eyes like, oh.
And then he's gonna be like, hey, you should watch out for this bridge in a couple of weeks. Right? That's what he does?
What did he say?
He forecasts the destruction of a bridge.
Oh, yeah. He's a harbinger of doom. Where was he to warn us about the world? Like, what the fuck is happening in the world right now? Shit's fucked. Thank God for Boner Bizarre.
Oh, you're right.
At least we get this little escape. As a treat. Forget about how much our lives suck all the time.
My life's great. What are you talking about? I get to dress up like the early discography of Kanye West.
Oh my God. I hate to say it, but dude, I miss you so much. I miss being on the stage with you. Oh yeah, sorry.
I'm sharp.
Alright, let's get down to business. Through the veil and into the realm of the Fae, welcome to the stage, Carla X! having. It's like, you know, Boner Bazaar is back. The Mexican pizza's back at Taco Bell. I'm having a Baja Blast. And tonight, we're all gonna live much. Taco Bell is not paying me to say this, but they fucking should be.
Taco Bell, if you can see us now, somehow, I'm not
please,
sure. Maybe you're Bigfoot and you can astral plane project. Please, send us coupons.
Please, we'll work for Taco Bell. I just want to be the Taco Bell of them all.
You already are the Taco Bell.
Really?
Boss, yes, of course. Look at this. Look at this diva. Look like you're ready to fight Spawn.
I want to fuck Spawn too. If you're a weird guy, I probably want to fuck you. I want to fuck the clown from Spawn, most of all. I feel like I am the clown from Spawn.
You mean the Violator?
Yes, the Violator. I wish I could fart a green cloud. That's so cool.
I feel like the Violator would be either really good or really bad at sex.
Okay, let's just talk about how that's John Leguizamo's best role.
Yeah, all right.
Name a better one. Actually, Ghetto Clown was fucking amazing. All right, we're gonna shut up and do the thing. All right, we're welcoming some new blood to our stage. Lena has been pole dancing for 2 years and recently brought her skills to the International Pole Convention.
We are stoked to initiate her into the cult of boner tonight. Please welcome Lena!
We'll be right back.
special night for us because I don't know if you heard, but for the first time ever, we sold out. We have no tickets at the door. Like, this is a first for us. So let me get a show of yells and screams. Is this your first time at Boner Bazaar? Wow, that many new people. Okay, how many of you have been here before?
Sounds about 50-50, actually.
Yeah, 50-50, yeah, all right, yeah. That's cool. Well, are you having a good time?
You're gonna come back, right, for the next one? Yeah, because we're gonna do more of these, right?
Definitely.
Okay.
If it's still legal. You know, we got some situations happening. I don't know how much longer we'll be able to do the things we like.
Let's put a positive spin on this. You can always stick it to the man by coming to our show.
Yes.
Right here, right now, you just being here, passively observing our strange banter is extremely, you know, how will I put this? It's extremely anti-authoritarian. Good for you.
And I'd like to add that right now in the world with all this fucked up shit happening, I just want to say that I think the world needs more stuff like this.
Yes, exactly. If you observe what we're setting up here right now.
There's a skeleton that has a dick. It's cool.
I don't know what this is, but the world needs more of it.
Well, how about we all find out what this is? This next performer likes to take it all off in the Dallas area, and she loves to let her panties drop in the city of Austin.
Whether her face is dripping in blood or flesh is peeling off her body, it's always a bloody mess. Please welcome La Pearl Necklace.
Many of you today will feel an overwhelming need to repent, for Lucifer has deceived you.
Goddess, and so apparently he was able to use me, even at a young age. I adore him, and so he used me, and what I do in this program is just teach people how to stop bowing down to the refrigerator and how to bow back down to him, how to bow back down to him.
Let's go, girls.
Judgment is coming, and we're all going to need pure and healing fellowship with sold-out Christians to make it through the terrible day.
I'm going out tonight. I'm feeling all right. Gonna let it all hang out. Wanna make some noise. Free to raise my voice. Yeah, I wanna scream and shout.
Oh, with them.
Watch out for that.
First three rows be getting wet. Don't worry, we've got some squirters tonight. All right, well, frankly, we can't talk about cult shit without bringing up the totalitarian nightmare that is Warren Jeffs and the fundamentalist Mormon cult. So at the time of his arrest in 2011, this sick motherfucker had over 70 wives. And at least 20 of them were under the age of 17.
Fuck Warren Jeffs! Fuck him!
Yes, absolutely fuck Warren Jeffs. A core tenet of the FLDS Church is the keep sweet doctrine, where women and children are reminded daily to keep sweet no matter what, giving up your own will to the priesthood. The teaching of this fucked belief system that we might actually be able to get behind is the doctrine of the blood atonement, which holds that certain sins can only be atoned for by the sinner's death.
Okay, the exact instructions for death under blood atonement are as follows. My throat be cut from ear to ear and my tongue torn out by its roots. Our breasts be torn open, our hearts and vitals torn out and given to the birds of the air and the beasts of the field. And our body be cut asunder, and all your bowels gush out. Wow, this actually would have worked in
Dude,
medieval
this
times.
Fucking metal.
Man, this is my audition for medieval times. I want to be the guy.
People are going to be like, I learned about FLDS from watching Stranger Things.
Please, go home and tell your friends and family about everything you've learned here today. Here to remind you to kill your oppressors and feed their vital organs to the birds are Villanelle and Siren Noir, joined for this performance by special guest Chris Thick Daddy Bullowing.
Let's fucking go!
Let's fucking go!
Keeping sweet is an exertion to remain clean and pure. If you're not keeping sweet, then you're not pure. Any feelings against your priesthood head is death to you. This is the law of God through the prophet to this people now.
Many young men, when they receive their first wife, are just so untrained. The woman, if she's not careful, will be overbearing and always ask permission for what she wants. And ladies, build up your husband by being submissive.
Dear wives, realizing happiness is only being a part and a strength to your husband, get close to him. Confess. abide in him. Don't let your former family be your total confidence. It should be your new husband. Turn to him with a full heart and give him the opportunity to lead you right.
Ensure that Boner Bazaar LLC continues to thrive economically for years to come. Thank you for securing our future.
God damn it, why is Boner Bazaar the coolest fucking thing ever?
Because we were born this way.
Well, you know.
We don't know how to stop.
We can't be stopped.
No, definitely not. That won't happen.
So what do you want to talk about?
Oh, yeah,
we can kill some time. Actually, yeah. What do you guys want to talk about? You guys want to talk about some shit?
Let's take some questions.
What?
Let's see.
Bigfoot!
There's a Bigfoot? Oh, my God!
I don't want to hear about Bigfoot!
Are you in luck?
let's go back to something else.
They want Bigfoot!
You're meant to be the bad guy here.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh,
sorry.
Okay, sorry.
I tried to get a chant going. It didn't work. It's not like it's not like wrestling where people are just like, this is awesome.
Absolutely. Absolute scum of the earth wrestling fans. I was here 2 weeks ago at a wrestling show. There were probably 30 people in this building. Tonight, I think we have over 500 people in the house tonight.
Yeah, but... Yeah, there's a lot of people here tonight. And thank you so much for that. I can't believe it myself. I told everyone, I was like, this show is gonna sell out. And everyone was like, no, that's impossible. And I was like, I am a powerful witch! So every full moon, bitches, I was manifested!
Yeah.
So there you go.
And you can pick up some lovely moon water and the merch
in the
back there.
The
so
back.
If you want to manifest something for your own life, that is an option.
Sure is.
Full Moon Apothecary.
Yes. So here at Boner Bazaar, we are big fans of the Satanic Temple and the work that they do. And the Satanic Temple is also here tonight, straight to the back. Please go check them out, see how you can get involved.
It's the guy with the devil horns, you can't miss it.
The Satanic Temple stands for empathy, reason, and advocacy in the face of the religious fundamentalists who are stripping away our human rights. You know, like right now.
Our next performer knows that we have all seen the painful and destructive powers of religious fanaticism. They are here to celebrate feminine independence and self-determination, especially when given the opportunity to live deliciously. Please welcome...
Give it up for Becca Strong!
Thank you.
just a quick little break, about 10 minutes. What I want you guys to do is get your little heinies to the back of the club, buy some merch, buy a raffle ticket, check out our sponsors, go to the bar, take a shot. If you want to do a shot with me, I fucking love Jameson. Make sure you're tipping your fucking bartenders. And yeah, give us 10 minutes. We'll be right back, right here.
It's time to begin again.
Tell.
So, the Fed Leader National is committed to
with Sarah's ritual offering and let us chant. Destroy the one. Saturn has come to devour the sun with divine weapon.
Say it.
You don't have to. It runs in old English, folks.
Get ready for Sarah Spark.
Sarah Spark.
Hell yeah!
concept of Boner Bazaar. Yeah.
Join the Boner Bazaar cult. Speaking of which, cults are everywhere.
Yeah.
Oh, is this me?
It's me. Did I mention that cults are everywhere? The intention of self-help is to refine, purify, and perfect to be like God. But at what point does the desire to improve and belong become a poison? That afterwork women's circle at the Cow Cow Bar? The innocent invitation to join the drum circle? These are all just granola steps towards the culture of martyrdom. And how delicious it is to martyr ourselves with others while smiling and bleeding out together. Jesus, what?
All right, right now, please welcome to the stage Stormy September.
That you experienced will forever define you.
the strip club. And just so everyone knows, I brought a keg to my birthday party at the strip club.
I think we asked them if you left the bodies on the floor.
Yes, the stripper told me that for my birthday, she would do any song I wanted. So I said, obviously, Papa Roach, Last Resort. And it was a full nude strip club because that's the only ones that are worth it. And I proceeded to scream the lyrics to Papa Roach's Last Resort directly into this goddess's pussy. And it was fucking tight.
They were very patient with us.
It was so cool. Honestly, that's when I peaked. That's it. After that, what am I still doing here? I don't know.
Well, there's going to be more strip club birthdays and bachelor parties, I'm sure.
I'm about to be 36. Who's coming to my birthday?
Yeah!
hip to the scene. This is not called fire breathing, it's called fire eating. They don't breathe it, they eat it. So, just so you know, I don't want you guys to feel like posers.
Know the difference.
I'm not gatekeeping, I'm letting you know.
Please be educated in fire safety.
Yes, please. Don't. Please do not burn this place down.
Thanks again to our crew members here for their setup, their tireless work. My friend here.
Oh my god, they're so good!
Wait, hold on. Take a bow. Take a bow.
Take a bow. Tyler
Reed,
everybody!
Tyler here looks like if Andrew WK started a lawn service. I love it. And set ourselves free.
Get ready to lose your fucking minds to MKUltra!
Let's go, MK!
Thank you.
you have to come to her birthday party.
Yeah.
That's the deal.
Have your abortion at my birthday party.
Okay,
have
your
abortion whenever the fuck you want.
So politically, like divine, you know, kill everyone now.
Eat shit, advocate cannibalism, and, you know, that.
We love new metal. The most political of all art forms.
Dude, I fucking love new metal, and it's not because I used to be a wrestler, but because when I was 12 years old, I was introduced to Limp Bizkit. And now things are the way they are, and I want to fucking break stuff.
I'm getting kinda hungry, baby.
screaming at us.
Well, hey,
wow, this is getting weird.
I tend to have that effect on most people. I make them fucking scream.
Please start hurting after the show.
What?
Hey, it's yelling nonsense. Boy, speaking of mushrooms, I had some of those invisible mushrooms earlier, and I'm feeling woozy.
Dude, I take so many mushrooms, I don't even feel anymore. I'm just
like, dude, all the time. Yo, I turned into a level of Sim City once.
You mean like Miami Vice?
No.
Which one?
Not Sim City. Sim City. I'm sorry.
Oh.
The city planning game.
Sorry, bitch, I don't play baby games.
It's a very adult game, of course.
No, it is not. What are they going to put out the next GTA?
Is anyone here now? Jesus! That was Shelby and Zoya. Praise goddamn Jesus. Sorry, Satanic Temple. Sorry for praising Jesus.
like I